This is Dr. Shashank. I have completed my MBBS from ESA Medical College, Rajajinagar. I'm batch of 2013. I have enrolled with medical mentor for NEET PG counseling. I've just given my NEET PG exam. Today I'm here to guide MBBS aspirants about NEET UG college selection. I have studied from ESA College, so I would like to tell you a few things about our college. I'll be starting with the college overview. Our college has been established around 100 years back, so our hospital has good inflow of patients. Though the UG course has started around 7 years back, the PG courses have been there from past 15 years. Ours is a well-established college which is situated in the heart of Bangalore. Ours is a 1000 plus bedded hospital with multiple specialties at the same place. All departments have a lecture theatre and a lab. Before our college was attached to the hospital, now they have built a new academic block with lecture theatres and labs. So it helps in new and informative learning. Our labs are well equipped. ESI has a very good patient flow. In fact, it's the second best hospital in terms of patient flow apart from Bangalore Medical College. That's because of the cashless service and the insurance card which the employees will have working from their respective factories. Our hospital is fully cashless, so there are no transactions made in cash anywhere. It also helps patient with super speciality referral to Ramayya, Sakra Hospital and others with the help of the insurance card. We have a department for all 19 subjects you study there, with one of the best being radio diagnosis. We have a very good medicine department, that I say because of the patient inflow and the OPD cases we have. We have around 150 to 200 cases daily. That's a huge number considering the amount of doctors who see the patients. And regarding practical exposure, we students get a lot of on-hand training. That's because one, it's a government hospital and there are too many patients to attend to for specialists, and two, naturally you'll have on-hand learning because teachers are willing to give you chances. Example, in ortho postings, we had done a lot of implant removals and operated on a lot of fracture cases. They give minor procedures to you, example, removal of a sebaceous cyst or a removal of lipoma in surgery. It really helps you learn and grow better as a practitioner and as a doctor. Coming to teaching, as it's a government college, you don't have much teaching experience there, but they do teach as much as they get, and you have a lot of postings where you learn a lot from patients. You get to see a variety of different cases. That's because many people can't afford private hospital care, so they come to ESI for treatment and get referred to super speciality hospitals from our college because of their insurance card. And coming to the hostel, there are two separate hostels for boys and girls, and it's different even for UGs and PGs. Me being a day scholar, I have no first-hand experience of how the hostel is, but as I've heard from my friends, they have 24-hour water facilities and electricity. Rules and regulations, as in we don't have any dress code to say, apart from grooming yourself well and looking at a lot of patients. We follow a formal dress code. Coming to higher study facilities, we have PGs only in major departments like OBG, surgery, medicine. The less minor specialties like ortho, radio, we don't have PGs as such.